The road to constant development requires constantly arming ourselves with new and better technology. Modernization theory attempts to understand this development of societies, a transition from traditional to a modern world. The theory takes into account the cultural and social aspects of a society that influence whether a society is willing to change its traditional methods of working. This theory originates from the ideas of German sociologist Max Weber and is described as a process of transition that involves the adoption of democracy with mass consumption, industrialization, urbanization, globalization, and bureaucracy. In his book, The Stages of Economic Growth, economist Wald Rostow theorizes the stages a society takes from being a traditional economy to a modern one. These stages begin with the traditional stage, the primal stage of any economy, small region, or entire country. At this point, there is no notion of a centralized nation or political system. The economy survives with the basic agricultural methodologies and is still largely dependent on hunting and gathering. The absence of modern technologies limits growth, resulting in a low standard of living and no individual economic mobility. As a society stabilizes and increases in size, there is a need for better, more productive, and more efficient ways to carry out agricultural tasks and trade. There is a demand for external goods and raw materials that initiates economic change and shifts the dynamics of traditional society. A centralized economy ensures robust mechanisms for both internal and external trade, which drives economic growth and increases individual economic mobility. Investment in changing the physical environment becomes widespread, with major developments in agricultural facilities, transportation, housing, and industry. Next, during the takeoff stage, societies become largely economy-based. With greater internal and external trade, globalization and urbanization will increase. Clear industrial sectors emerge, like agriculture, textiles, and energy, and the production of secondary goods becomes more prevalent than in primary sectors. The takeoff stage requires a lot of capital, which could be from taxes the states collect, and other fiscal measures, such as investment from domestic and foreign entities. The maturity stage is where economies have successfully applied various modern technologies to the majority of their resources. The economy now finds its place in the global frontier. As technology develops further, new sectors emerge and accelerate as old ones level off. There is a shift in the workforce from agriculture to industries and technology, a decrease from 75% working in agriculture to only 20%. Investment in large-scale infrastructure like schools, universities, and hospitals is carried out. The diversity of sectors and the availability of jobs raise the standard of living and reduce the poverty rate. In the mass consumption stage, the agricultural industry fades even further as new industries begin to dominate the economy. Higher individual economic mobility gives way to higher spending power for individuals. Earlier concerns about basic survival are basically forgotten, as individuals are often brought up in existing wealth and comfort. Now, the modernization theory does have critics, who argue that the theory and model do not consider the differences between capitalistic and communist societies. Modernization theorists see Western economies as completely modern and deem other economies unevolved or primitive. Although the modernization theory shows the influence of technology and other social aspects on making a society modern, it fails as a universal explanation for societal progress outside of capitalistic Western societies.